And not this one? My titles. My position in life is we are what we do, so that I'm doing molecular gastronomy. Well, my first name is Hervé. My family name is Tis. I'm from Kienza, which is a village in Alsace. So it would make Hervé Tis for Kienza. It was in the fifth district of Paris. It was the new flat of my parents. We just moved, and it was Christmas because I got a chemistry box, and I did this experiment of blowing into lime water and see the turbidity. And it was so wonderful that all my life was I fall into chemistry. Now there is another contribution called note by note cooking, which is cooking completely differently for the future, which is the equivalent of synthetic music, but it will be synthetic cooking. Note by note cooking is probably the future of food, so, or perhaps the future of food, I don't know. Using some knowledge from science in order to invent new dishes. So I invented a lot of new dishes. In terms of innovation, it's crazy. In terms of spoilage, it's better. In terms of anything, it's very exciting. You have the pure compounds, water, cellulose, starch, amylose, amylopectin, proteins. And with that, you make a dish. In meat, you have 25% proteins, which are there, and 75% water. So let's take protein, water, and cook it, and you get a Dirac. It's a reproduction of meat with the same kind of qualities. Okay, so we have the taste, we have the color, we will have the consistency. Now we just fry a steak. The mixture, it will be like a pancake, but the pancake and a steak, you see, is not so different. Okay. So the flavor, oh, it's tender. Not so bad. The pH scale is very important because at low pH and high pH, you would not have the same mechanism of chemical process. Okay, I would say that the pH is 4, which is not much. Ah, I know. It's not almond, it's benzaldehyde. Now it's completely different. It's done. It's a Veuler sauce. My friend Pierre Gagnère, who's one of the best chefs of the world, is serving this sauce. It was with roasted lobster. It was good.
When you're determined to brew the world's best beer, you discover a thing or two along the way. In 1909, Carlsberg invented the pH scale to improve beer quality and shared it with the world.